So I see, and this is something that a lot of people would disagree with, I see the opposite of being a rebel as exactly the opposite is being conventional. Conventional, to me, is a dirty word. It means really at the base, either unwilling or unable to think for oneself. And this is something that most of you have not seen or thought out for yourselves. You're kinder than me, so you give the benefit of the doubt more than I would on this. But it's my contention, I've said it to you before, but I'm really emphasizing it tonight, and maybe for the first time really emphasizing it, that the average person, by the average person, I mean the majority of people, and I'm only talking about people that could legitimately be called fairly conventional, and I don't mean ultra-conventional, I just mean conventional enough. They really don't question the ideas of society, they don't really question the meaning of things. They kind of just are concerned with having a good life, so to speak, quote unquote good life. And they're not people who would leave their particular country or their particular area if things radically changed. They don't think in those terms. They don't have those reactions. My contention is that the vast majority of people have never had an original thought from cradle to grave. I probably don't have or couldn't come up with a way to convince you, but I don't have the slightest doubt about it. And I see it all the time. And when I say it to other people in my life, they kind of look at me like I'm headed to the cuckoo farm. They think it's a little too extreme, a little too harsh, a little too not giving the benefit of the doubt. But I don't agree. Because of my friends not agreeing, I've thought about it long and hard for years and years and gone back and forth. Am I too extreme on that or not? And I finally came to the conclusion once and for all that I wasn't extreme enough. That conventionalism's natural end is fascism. Conventional-minded thinking's natural result, given the right circumstances, is Nazism. But what's the basis of conventionalism? What's the basis of a person living their life from birth to death, 70, 80, 90 years, in purely conventional terms? The real basis, if you ask me, is they have never been taught or figured out how to think for themselves, and they have never realized that they're not thinking for themselves. What they say and what they think are simply repetitions of things they've heard, things they've read, or things that everybody kind of knows. And they are simply saying somebody else's view without at all being aware of it, without at all having the notion that this is not my own thinking, this is not my own idea, this is not my own feeling, it's borrowed. It's absorbed from the mass culture, and then I put it out as if it were my own thought. And whole conversations all day long, all over the country, are simply two people or three people or four people saying something borrowed to each other and having a dialogue back, borrowed this, okay, and my answer to you is this, and it's all borrowed, and there's no originality, there's no independent mind going on whatsoever. And that doesn't mean they're bad people. That just means that thinking hasn't really sprung up in their life. Their form of thinking is just the same as memorization, repeating what they've heard or read somewhere else, usually the day before, most typically in daily conversation. So their opinions aren't theirs. Their opinions are what they think most people think. They are concerned with fitting in. They are concerned consciously with conforming, with being as much like everyone else as possible. It's a value. It's a value of the conventional mind that I will have a better life, I'll be happier, I'll succeed more, the more I am like the majority of other people I meet and see and know. And the more I'm different, the more I'm out on a limb. Because if I'm really different, I could be wrong. If the majority says this is the right way to live, and a few people, or just I, say, no, this way is better, what's the chances that the majority's right and I'm wrong versus I'm right and the majority's wrong? And that's the conventional mind, the conventional thinking, is if the majority says it, if 100 people say it versus one, a better chance that the 100 are right, which is absolutely not true. In fact, the mass mind is the mob mind, and the mob mind is the lowest common denominator, and the lowest common denominator is the lowest thinking. Your least intelligent possibility is what gets put forward. So it's actually a truism of life that often the very opposite of the conventional idea is true. The majority is more often wrong than certain individuals not acting intelligently. Mobs don't act intelligently. And it's the individual or a small group rather than the majority that may be more capable of sorting things out, being reasonable, bringing intelligence to bear, and coming up with something that's true and good versus the majority, which is just going with the easy way, going with non-controversy, going the way that it doesn't require learning how to think for yourself.